All right, YouTube, good morning. James here with the Buscemi Family Channel, bringing to you our latest video. Just started my morning workout. It's like 6:15 on Thursday morning, and I just love being up at this time. It's like a quiet world. It's still dark out. I get to think about all the things I want to do and plan my day. But the purpose of this particular video is to talk a little bit about starting my next business. I just started my next business. And I wanted to tell you all the steps that I'm taking so that if someone wants to start their own business, they'll have the understanding of everything that you need to do to start a business. So check it out. All right, YouTube. So starting my next business, you know, what I've recognized over the years or began to understand is that what stops people from starting a business is that there's some administrative stuff that they're unsure of, or there's business risk involved. And because of some of those things that you have to do in the beginning, people kind of let their minds get the best of them. But I'm gonna tell you step by step all the things that you need to do to start a business. The particular business that my wife and I have just started is a retail business. So I'm gonna speak in terms of a retail business, because depending on the business that you're opening, there might be some slightly different steps. But what I will say is that there's absolutely nothing difficult about starting a business in terms of the administrative stuff and negotiating contracts and things like that. None of it is overly challenging. Your mind might tell you that it's overly challenging, but if you know how to use a computer, if you speak the English language, if you have any sense of thought process or problem solving, you should be able to figure out with ease. So let's get right into it. My wife and I have opened up a retail business. We have signed what is called a letter of intent for a retail space. What is a letter of intent? When you are looking for a retail space, obviously you're reaching out to the various landlords in the local area or wherever it is that you want to open up your business. And you're saying, I want to open up a business. I need X amount of square feet. Obviously, you should have that in your mind previous to speaking to the developer or the landlord, or the realtor that's representing the developer or the landlord. So you should understand exactly how many square feet you want and need. And you're saying, this is the square footage I need. I'm looking for a 3-year lease, a 5-year lease, or 10-year lease. So these are some of the items that you want to have in your mind. When you're signing an LOI, basically what you're saying to them is that you intend on moving forward to signing a lease. And what the LOI shows is basically the terms of the lease. It'll state such things as the length of the lease, if there's any personal guarantees. So what's a personal guarantee? A personal guarantee is when you sign a retail lease, they want you to personally guarantee either the life of the lease or whatever it is that you negotiate. Okay, which means basically that if the business fails, they want you to personally guarantee that you're going to pay out the entire lease. And hence, there's the business risk. I always recommend to anyone that you negotiate the personal guarantee. You say to them, if you sign a 5-year lease, I don't want a 5-year personal guarantee. Let's split the risk. I'll take a 2-year or a 2.5 or a 3-year personal guarantee on a 5-year lease. Other items that are in the letter of intent would be if you want an option for another lease after the term of that lease concludes. So if you sign a 3-year lease, you might want to have an option for another 3 years. You want that in there because you don't want someone else to come in and take your space if you have a successful business. Other items that are in the LOI or the letter of intent, you want to make sure that you say such things as, I want a working HVAC unit. They might say to you, the HVAC, the air conditioner, it's on you to maintain. However, before you take that space, you want to say to them, that's fine. However, I commit to making sure that it's a working and functionable and efficient HVAC unit before I take over the space. Additionally, many times when you sign a retail lease, they will allow you to have what is called TI money, tenant improvement money, or build out money. You want to try to negotiate build out money. They might give you $10,000, they might give you $15,000, depending on the size of the space and how good you are as a tenant. They're going to potentially give you money to build out the space so that you could build it out in such a way that it fits your needs. Hey, you want to negotiate build out money. First of all, this mitigates your startup costs. So hypothetically, if you are able to get $10,000 from the landlord for build out, this helps you in lessening your expenditure when you're fixing the space to your liking, right? So you might be taking over a space that was a deli, but you want to make it a clothing store. Well, obviously you need to construct a clothing store. You need to get all the grease off the walls. You need to change the floor. You need to paint. You need to get new tile and so forth. If you're able to negotiate TI money into that letter of intent, that is good for you and will lessen your expenditure. So these are some of the items that are in there. There's other little details and items, but you should really make sure that you're negotiating in that letter of intent all the things that you want and need. Many landlords will be flexible. They want you in their space. They don't want that space to be left vacant for too long because that means they're losing money. So make sure that you're able to negotiate and ask someone who's done it before. Ask someone, hey, what are some of the things that I should look out for? There's other items that I could get into, which will take too long for this particular video. The other item, other items that are important for you to understand. You will need what is called a business tax receipt. Okay? For example, I'm opening up a retail business in Delray Beach, Florida. I'm gonna need a business tax receipt for Delray Beach, which is the local municipality, as well as Palm Beach County. What is a business tax receipt? A business tax receipt is basically a general business license that says you're opening up a business in a particular geographic location and you're paying the municipality and the county to open up that business. It might be called something differently in whatever state you reside in or whatever state you're opening up a business in, but most of the time it's called either a business tax receipt or a business certificate. Again, if you're able to use a computer, if you're able to use a keyboard, it's just a few simple questions and might cost you a few $100, but it is not hard to do. Simply go online, Google business tax receipt Delray Beach, Florida, business tax receipt Orlando, Florida, wherever it is, business tax receipt Palm Beach County, okay? It's imperative that you get this because this allows you to open up a business in Florida or whatever geographic location you're in. Lastly, if you are reselling items, you're buying items from a wholesaler, you're placing them in your store, and then you're reselling them to the public. This means that you're a reseller and you need to get what is called a reseller tax certificate. It might be called something slightly different again in whatever municipality, whatever state you're in, but what a reseller license means is you're gonna buy tangible items from a wholesaler. You're not gonna pay taxes on those items. Then you're gonna place them in your store and you're gonna sell them to that person that walks in your store. We call that person the end user. That end user is going to pay sales tax. In the state of Florida, it's 6%. There also might be like a 1% sales tax. For Palm Beach County, you wanna know how much tax you're putting on those tangible items. Again, it's a Google search away. Any person that knows how to use a computer can figure it out. But what the reseller tax certificate allows you to do is resell items for adding tax to the end user. You are then responsible quarterly or annually or monthly, depending on what schedule you choose or what it is in your particular geography, you are then responsible to pay those taxes that the end user paid on that tangible item back to the state. In my case, it would be the state of Florida. So you're signing an LOI if you have a retail space. If you continue on, you're going to sign a lease, which will have the parameters of that LOI in the lease. You are getting a business tax receipt for the county. You are getting a business tax receipt for the local municipality. And if you're opening up some type of reseller type business, retail business, where you're buying from wholesale and selling those tangible items to the end user, you need a reseller tax certificate. That's all you need to do. This might take you 2 or 3 days. So all those people that are thinking to themselves, there's too much to do. I don't even know what to do. It's too hard. There's so many moving parts. That's all you have to do, in large part. Now, is there a ton of work involved in building out your space, in talking to wholesalers, getting your product going, whatever that might be, marketing, advertising? Of course, that's a tremendous amount of energy and effort. However, getting a business up and running is not a hard thing to do. What I didn't mention up front, and I want to also mention, of course, is you have to create a business entity. Creating a business entity, not hard to do. In the state of Florida, you go to a website called SunBiz. In each state, they have their own like state website where you would create a business entity with regard to that state. And you're gonna either create a sole proprietorship, a partnership, an LLC, an S corp, a C corp. I particularly like LLCs. And typically, if there's multiple members in an LLC, what is a member? A member's owners. Okay, if there's multiple members in that LLC, typically you then create an S corp. That's how I like to do it. That's how I've been instructed to do it. And that's how I've done it in my past businesses. All I do is ask my accountant, hey, what is the most beneficial business entity for me to have with this particular business to mitigate my tax burden and to put myself in the best position to pay as little taxes as possible and to be able to realize the fruits of our labor. So creating that business entity, business tax receipts for the local municipality as well as the county, reseller tax certificate. All these items are super easy and you should be able to do it. So don't let these things hold you back. Go for it. I'm gonna bring to you everything that I'm doing with regard to this new business. I'm not telling you what the business is yet because I've just signed an LOI. I have not signed the lease yet. As soon as I sign the lease, I will bring it all to you and I'm gonna bring the process to you so you could see all the things that we do, every step we take. If it's a bad step, I'm gonna bring it to you. If it's a great step, I'm gonna bring it to you. But when you start a business in the United States of America, you are giving yourself the chance. All I ever wanted was the chance. And I've taken it in the past and I'm taking it again. And I am putting my destiny in my hands, in no one else's. It's not up to that guy. It's not up to that guy. It's not up to the government to help me. It's up to me to win or lose. And I'm gonna win, bringing it all to you. Please subscribe to the channel.